Coins have been used for currency for a really long time. From as far back as 600 BCE, we have evidence of people using coins as a means of trade. So it's understandable that a few have fallen from a pocket or two over time and left to get buried, sunk, or lost. And along that journey, get really, really dirty. Here's where you ask, dirty coins? Crystal, that sounds gross. Why don't we just forget about them? Well, look at this. If you happen to find one of these coins, you just made yourself over $10 million. This is the flowing hair dollar, made in 1794 to 1795 as legal tender in the United States, and it is the rarest and most sought after collector's coin. Bet you'll be cleaning any coins you find from now on, right? Now, a common method of cleaning coins are submerging them in one of two solutions. Hydrogen peroxide, H2O2, and Coca-Cola. I actually prefer Coke Zero, but that's just me. Today we're going to be seeing which one of these two is most effective at cleaning a dirty coin. So let's just start off our experiment by putting our coins first in the Coke and then the hydrogen peroxide. To run our experiments, besides having just our two cleaning solution, we need some dirty coins. Here are some extremely disgusting specimens. Okay, so this is the experiment setup. We have samples A and B of Coca-Cola and C and D of the hydrogen peroxide. Water, H2O, is our control sample. The control samples show what would happen to the coin if it wasn't in one of the cleaning solutions. Let's get started. So, first coin into sample A. Nothing happens. You see there are bubbles. Those are the carbonation bubbles from the Coca-Cola. Let's try the same thing, coin number two in solution B of Coca-Cola. Some bubbles came up, but nothing really happened. This is our sample to go into the control sample. We don't expect anything to happen in this one. And it looks like we're right. So now, first coin in sample C, hydrogen peroxide. Not too much is happening, kind of like the water. And again, another sample into solution D. Nothing is really happening. Oh wow, look at solution C. The coin actually changed into a gold color and bubbles are all around the sample. This is really interesting. This is our control sample. As we expected, nothing's really happening. In the sample in solution A, you can see there are some bubbles coming to the surface. Sample B, not too much is happening in sample B. Look at all the bubbles forming on the surface of the coin. So many bubbles. Now, I know what you're thinking. It's gotta be the bubbles. It's actually deeper than that. The bubbles in Coke come from carbonation, which is the carbon dioxide escaping the liquid that was forced in there with high pressure. And in hydrogen peroxide, the bubbles are a result of a whole nother reaction taking place inside. For Coca-Cola, the cleaning action comes from the phosphoric acid, H3PO4, which is used to give soda a tart flavor. It is actually what is known as a weak acid, and it lowers the pH of a solution, making it more acidic. Now, hydrogen peroxide. You may have seen this used to clean minor wounds and burns, but the reaction that sterilizes a boo-boo is the same that will clean a dirty coin. Stepping back a little bit, what is actually the gunk on the surface of those coins? Well, it could be many things. Most likely, it's probably a combination or some combination of random contamination, like organic material, like gum, dirt, oil from your fingers, just anything really, and the metal oxides that form on the surface of the coin metal itself. So how does this work? Well, in the case of phosphoric acid, that is in the Coca-Cola and maybe other sodas, it is the acid, the weak acid, in a solution, it dissolves the surface contaminants on the coin. On the other hand, in the hydrogen peroxide, the bubbles we see come up at first, even though it's very exciting, usually it's more likely that it's the hydrogen peroxide breaking down itself, releasing oxygen gas, O2, and maybe some of the hydrogen peroxide is reacting with the surface of the metal itself and dissolving the metal oxides. So, in both cases, the solutions are reacting with the surface of the coin, but in different mechanisms. One is dissolving the surface, and one is actually reacting with it. Hey, and we're back. It's been 18 hours since we started our experiment. Let's see how our samples look. Okay, you can see in our sample A, the soda is flat, so there are no more bubbles. As we examine sample B, it looks pretty much the same as sample A. As far as we can tell now, anyways. In our control sample, looks like nothing has happened. Sample C, this one is looking crazy. The solution has changed colors. Our coin is still bubbling. There are so many bubbles. This is sample D. There are bubbles, but the color looks pretty much the same. This is sample A, and this is the control sample. Wow, sample A is looking a lot cleaner. This is sample B next to the control sample. Wow, look how shiny sample B is looking. It is so clean. Sample C next to the control sample. Wow, sample C is looking kind of crazy. This was from the solution that was bubbling. This is sample D next to the control sample. Is it looking cleaner? I think so. It's a little bit less green. Okay, so we just saw, compared to our control sample, both cleaning solutions did an equally good job on average. Sample B came out the cleanest in the Coca-Cola, and sample C is the cleaner of the two in the hydrogen peroxide. It makes sense because both cleaning solutions, although they use a different mechanism, are reacting with the contamination at the surface of the coin. If I were to pick, I would say probably Coca-Cola would be the safer way to clean the coin, as the hydrogen peroxide could damage the coin's surface. So there you have it! Both solutions are about equal in terms of cleaning coins. Many coin collectors, serious coin collectors, recommend oil and water as a more gentle method of cleaning a coin to preserve its detail. But if it's so dirty that you can't see any of the features, you have an option of dunking it into one of these two solutions. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe. Hit the like button right here. See you next week on Molecularly Crystal.